In today's video, I am going to be breaking down my top stocks for October 2021. The first couple of stocks will be Canadian, and the next couple of stocks will be also American stocks. Let's get down, let's check these out. The first one is TD Bank. Now, why is this a top stock this month? Well, number one, I personally absolutely love Canadian banks. They pay a very, very good dividend, and this is the reason why. The PE ratio is the lowest out of the big six banks in Canada. And when we start really looking at the banks, anytime that they have a lower than 10 PE ratio, it usually does not stay that way for very long. So because of that, I am believing that this is going to have a little bit of headroom coming up, and it's going to be absolutely massive. Maybe not huge like a 20% gain, but I could easily see a good 3 to 5% gain on TD Bank and any of the other Canadian banks that are close to a 10 PE ratio. It does currently pay 3.72%, and technically they haven't raised their dividend for a while now because they haven't been allowed to. The Canadian government's basically stopping them from being able to because of the coronavirus. Let's face it, it kind of looks bad if a bank is making killer earnings, raising their dividend, paying out their investors more money while the economy is in a recession. So that's probably why they're not allowed to, and they probably wouldn't have because they don't want that negative PR. But next year, they're gonna be probably raising their dividend. As soon as that no dividend limit is basically released, we'll be fine. We'll be getting dividends. I mean dividend increases, but also check out the volume. The volume is pretty solid as well. When it comes to the earnings, this is what I'm basically talking about. They've had three blowout quarters. They've had the last quarter still a pretty good beat, however, not as massive as the previous three. And we're seeing that there could be a little bit of a not so huge of an increase quarter after quarter that we see in the fourth quarter here. However, I personally feel that it's going to be potentially a blowout because we have seen increased jobs happening, or at least job openings in Canada, and the fourth quarter is possibly going to be looking not too shabby. At least that's what we're seeing so far. This could change over the next little while, however. We've also seen before the pandemic a revenue rise year over year, same as earnings rising year over year. Now, when it comes down to 2020, we have seen lesser revenues. However, check out those earnings. They actually made more money than they did the previous year, which means that they are learning how to make more money off of earnings, or at least make more money off of the revenue that they are creating, which means, in my opinion, that if that continues, we're going to see even more earnings and higher earnings going into the future when revenues get back to normal. Now, something with most of the big six banks is they basically traded sideways for about 2 years, 2.5 or so years. And then, of course, the pandemic hit and they tanked. And then they kind of traded sideways for a bit. TD had a double bottom. It was looking fantastic. Huge, huge increases. And of course, we got that triple top. Not that great of a look of a chart, but now we have that double bottom. I think that this could be a big factor right now going into the future. Now, this is my own personal opinions. Never trust a random person online. Do your own research. As we can see, we have not seen a massive increase or even an increase at all when it comes to the dividend. Now, this is obviously different than the American version of TD Bank stock. I have seen so many comments online saying, oh my God, TD's lowered their dividend. Oh my God, they've raised their dividend. They haven't done anything with their dividend. What the American stock is doing is basically mirroring the Canadian stock's dividend. And because there's currency involved, that's why you see a fluctuation when it comes to the dividend. However, what we can see is usually once a year they do raise their dividend. And we can see that they have not raised their dividend for well over a year and a half. That's going to continue. We're not going to be seeing a dividend increase most likely this year. We're going to be most likely seeing it next year, which means that it's 2 years without an increased dividend. And as we can see, if we were to obviously... knowing that whatever happens in the past is not going to happen in the future, but if we look and put together the last two dividends that, or increases of the dividend that we've seen with TD, then what we can kind of guess is what we can see in the future. So we've seen a 5-cent dividend raise, and then we also seen a 7-cent dividend raise. So that was a 10% rise. To be accurate, it's 10.4. And this was a 6.75% raise. So we can assume that going into the future, the next dividend rise could be lesser or greater, obviously, than either 12 cents roughly, or it could be a rise of maybe, I could take a guess, at about 17%. Which then would make that dividend rise or raise, which could be about 13.5-ish cents. So we could see about a 12 to 13 cent dividend raise in the new year, or it could be higher or it could be lower, which would then bring us to about a 92 cent dividend. Now, of course, whatever happens in the past is no guarantee what's going to happen into the future. This dividend could be a massive rise or raise, and then it could also be not as big either. So we never know what's going to happen, but that's just a guess as to what I think it could become. Enbridge is the next company I'm going to talk about, and the dividend yield is 6.5%. That's absolutely massive. The volume is through the roof as well. And what we are also seeing is a lower PE versus other pipeline companies. It's not the lowest, but it's on the low end. When it comes to their earnings, they've had two very good quarters, they've had two very bad quarters, and they've had a very bad year in 2020. However, they were still able to make money, and there's some really positive news when it comes to Enbridge. When it comes to Enbridge stock, they've had a little bit of a pullback recently, and we can see on their website that they are really heavily starting to invest in green energy, because we all know that oil and oil prices are going to be going through the roof over the next little while. It's getting harder and harder for companies to drill for oil, and it's getting harder and harder for companies to move oil around, which then puts even more stress on the pipelines and puts even more stress and, of course, money in the pockets of Enbridge. They also raise their dividend substantially every single year as well. They've also had a pretty drastic pullback from 5 years ago. Now, before all of this coronavirus, we were seeing a very steady chart to the upside. Now, with that spike above that trend line, that should have shown that it was going to go and explode to the upside. However, what we've seen was a drastic pullback because of the coronavirus. Many people were not driving as much, not as much shipping, which then turned around and was ridiculous, and now there's stupid costs on shipping. We also seen a double bottom and a double bottom there, which is kind of interesting why it went back down. But either way, we did see a massive double bottom, and we are starting to see, again, the trends continuing to the positive and still a pullback from its previous tops. So to me, that tells me that this is a pretty good company to invest in. And this is what I mean by the drastic increases on the dividends. We can see that there was only a 2.5 cent increase this past year. However, we've seen a much larger dividend increase the year before that, and also a pretty good increase the year before that. When we start really moving down this chart and we look at, let's say, 10 years ago at 28.3 cents, we look at 28.3 cents, and now we look at 83 cents, and we're looking at a little over three times higher they've increased their dividend 3+x, which is absolutely amazing. Considering that TD is 2.4, this is well over 3, you're looking at, if you were going to hold this for many years, you're going to be making more and more money in the future. Apple is a great American stock to invest in, and there is one reason why it's on this list. Obviously, they pay a very small dividend, but they're making more money. They're making a killing. They've had 4 great quarters. They've had a massive run. They have really started to stabilize near that all-time high, and they've basically had a little bit of a pullback recently from its top. The only thing to really keep an eye on, though, however, is the fact that if interest rates continue to rise when it comes to bonds, what we're looking at is the tech sector going to start sliding. So that's kind of the fine line. The issue, or the not so big of an issue in my opinion, is the fact that Apple, in my opinion, is a blue chip stock, and many other opinions as well think that it's a blue chip stock and it's going to be safe no matter what. And if you have some short-term pain when it comes to the stock price and going down, that's just a good option to get back or get even more of that stock. So keep that in mind. Personally, anytime that there's anywhere between a 3 and 8% pullback on Apple, it's usually a good time to kind of start getting into it. They do continuously increase their dividend, but it's not a massive dividend. So you're not investing in this stock for the dividend, you're investing in it for the growth. Pfizer is the next company. They pay a 3.5% dividend. And there is a very good reason why I'm picking this stock now. We're starting to see more and more countries saying that they're going to be basically having the third dose of the vaccine going out to more and more people. And in my opinion, that is good for their stock because obviously they are supposedly the best vaccine according to, the news that I watch, which is like news here in Hamilton. But either way, when we're looking at Pfizer, they continuously have what's so-called, I guess you could say, a better vaccine. Who knows if it's better or not, but when it comes down to it, the Canadian government saying there's like a 1 in 50 or 75 or something like that thousand chance of having that heart condition with kids, and then with the Moderna one, there's like a 1 in 7,000 or 5,000 chance, or whatever it is, they tend to have a better name on their vaccine, which means that they're going to sell more of it, and because of that, I think that's going to be an absolute amazing boom for Pfizer. Also, for the fact that the US government wants to invest more money into mRNA vaccines and mRNA just technology. So to me, that means that Pfizer is going to be starting to get government contracts and government money to develop even more of this. And if the government's going to be spending your money and giving it to Pfizer, you might as well get it back in the dividend. The last quarter, they did very good. They beat earnings estimates by a ton. I'm kind of interested in that, the fact that 2020 was not a very big revenue year considering, but I don't know. That's just something that stands out in my eyes. It should have been huge, but maybe those vaccines, the sales, maybe they won't hit until 2021, which would make sense, but I thought they were starting to take money back in 2020. We have seen a little bit of a pullback as well. We've seen about roughly 10% pullback from the top, and it's kind of tested very close to that range. So if it bounces off this level it's at right now, it seems to be a very strong buy going into the future. And they do tend to raise their dividends slightly often, I could say. Kind of often. Every once in a while. Not usually massive increases. Until recently, we've seen a 3-cent increase, so that's kind of promising. So that's my picks for October. I hope that you've enjoyed. Hit that like button, subscribe. Remember, don't just trust a random person online. Do your own research. I hope that you've enjoyed. I'll see you guys again next time.